relieved at like about him not like being a bother, a burden in our life.
It's gonna be a lot less bullets coming through her windows now with him gone.
Salute the regular Degla. Something wrong with the Sun Man mind. Facts.
I see anger, man. You know, I see anger because she won't be able to get any more food stamps. Less food stamps, less crab legs. Or maybe that's just me. I don't know.
Nah, he was over. He was over the food stamp age, man. She wasn't getting it for him.
Yeah. You know, another thing too, like these women, like so much crime. There's so much crime. Then you mix that with the fact that they don't really, like, sisters don't really have, like, empathy and like, sisters don't have that same thing like a white girl might have. Like, a white girl or a Hispanic girl, we're all different, right? All the root groups are different. Sisters are kind of callous, man. They are kind of callous, man. They lead the thing about it. They have the most abortions. That's something that, you know, speaks to a callousness. You know what I'm saying? If you lead the country in murdering your babies in a efficient a saline type of way. It's kind
of
like a
sterile sort of
sterile way of murdering your kids. Then like a lot of things sisters do are callous. You know what I'm saying? Like the fact that, you know, they have many baby fathers or many children's fathers. They're pretty callous. I can see the callousness in other aspects of sisters that shows up when we see them in these interviews, man. I can see that. Salute to Deluxe 247, aka Cal Ripken, aka the real MVP, coming through once again. Salute to Eric S, Op Nation Hall of Famer. And we haven't been able to get over 300 tonight, man. That's crazy. The numbers, I don't know what's going on with YouTube, man. Why the numbers so low tonight? I have no idea, man, but we'll get to that. We'll let me see something.
Some hidden camera stuff here.
Yeah, I don't know.
Certainly there have been times where, you know.
Let's see. All right. Here we go.
Certainly there have been times where, you know, there's no way we're hiring a white male.
Just kind of unspoken.
There are times when it's spoken, but
how would they say it?
There's no way we're hiring a white male. They say
like straight to you, or okay.
They'd be very careful how they message that to agents.
According to these videotapes, Disney blatantly discriminates against whites, white men in particular.
I think I'm sort of like well prepared for it. I'm well positioned for it. But as far as Disney's concerned, I'm a white male. That's not who they're looking to promote at the moment.
As a white guy, even Michael has his own doubts about the possibility for advancement for himself at Disney. In fact, Michael actually got to experience Disney's discrimination against white males firsthand.
You know, I've been at the company 11 years now, so I have friends in HR and I have friends in those divisions. And they're like, look,
his gay privilege,
nobody else is
going
to tell you this, Mike, but they're not considering any white males for a shot. They're just not. Yeah, it's not really one.
They even passed over a qualified half-black person for a promotion because they didn't look black enough.
We wanted to hire somebody in the department a few years ago now. Who was half black, but didn't like appear half black. And there was a creative executive who was like, we're not, like, that's not what's going on. Like, they wanted somebody in meetings who would appear a certain way, and he wasn't gonna bring that to the meeting. I mean, it kind of feels like we're, you know, at some point there's going to be a lawsuit. That's kind of how it feels, just because of, you know,
And that is a lawyer talking. So how does Disney explain pushing these discriminatory practices? They use code words and buzzwords.
I'm guessing that there is a acceptable code words and buzzwords that are used to explain what they're looking for. They might say something like, you know, look, we're not looking at like the usual suspects for this job. You know? So it's like not like a legally actionable thing, but everybody knows what it means. They, you know, the writers and actors hear all the time, like, you know, looking to hire writers and actors who bring diversity. I'm not looking to bring on any more clients who are like.
Welcome to the Disney Tapes. My name is James O'Keefe, standing here in Burbank, California, outside Disney corporate headquarters. This is our first part in a series about blatant discrimination and woke policies at the Walt Disney Company. To say that the Disney Company has had a tumultuous 5 years, well, that would be an understatement. Major box office flops, a losing battle with the state of Florida, and a stock that is one of the worst performers on Wall Street. And as you'll probably conclude from this report, as well as recent shareholder rumblings, almost all of Disney's recent failings are as a result of Bob Iger and the cast of characters here at Disney that are trying to force woke DEI policies into every aspect of Disney's vast media empire. What used to be a highly profitable company by being the gold standard of family entertainment has taken a sharp downturn in the wake of all of its wokeness. Under CEO Bob Iger's leadership, Disney's downfall likely started with the insane hiring practices amongst its executives and creative teams. One of their top senior vice presidents claims that they not only discriminate against white men when recruiting and hiring middle management, they actually give bonuses for hiring and retaining employees that are specifically not white. According to these videotapes, Disney blatantly discriminates against whites, white men in particular. Not a week goes by without a news headline about potential medical supply shortages, threats to our infrastructure or power grid. And you remember what they pulled during the last pandemic. Certain medications were mysteriously out of stock. No way will I ever let that happen again.
Eric S., man, what's up? Eric?
Yes.
What's going on?
Yeah, can you hear me? Oh, big fan of the show.
Yeah, salute you, Eric S. from Cash App.
Yes.
Salute to you, bro. Salute to you, man. This brother donates every episode, man. Salute to you, man.
So, yeah, that's hey, my salute. Oh, thank you. That's my hometown, Fort Ice. I wanted to chime in. I, you know, it was my first time calling in on a live show.
Mm-hmm. Go ahead.
So, I was born and raised there. I went to K-12 there. I was up to there about 21, 22. I go down about three, four times a year, do a little hunting, you know, just family get together, stuff like that, and whatever. So it just, you know, it's kind of
what we saw. What we saw there is that what the women are like there, or is that was just aberration?
No, that's pretty much what it's like. You know, I mean, it was. You know, the town done shrunk. It was about 5,600 when I was living there. And the town done shrunk a lot. You know, I didn't realize it was down 3,200. I mean, it definitely changed. You know, I see all the stuff change and stuff. So it's a great little town or whatever. I mean, it's some, you know, it's pretty sunny, but, you know, it can be, you know, sketchy at times. There's been some stuff, you know, maybe don't make the news or maybe don't make the government more, but it's been a pretty good town for the most part and whatnot.
Mm. It seemed like a place, a good place to retire if you want to stay out of the way and you still want to be around some people that look like you. What you think? Slow, nice and slow like that?
Yeah, it's definitely slow. I mean, my folks, they still there. I'm going there next month, actually. I got aunties and uncles still there. So everybody, you know, people that's always worked, you know, a lot of jobs hell left out of the town. So they go on to the next town over. People, you know, commute 30 miles away to, you know, to different manufacturing and things of that nature. But, I mean, it was a great town, you know, coming up. It wasn't no race, you know, races, you know. Y'all was, like I said, I'm growing up in South Arkansas. You never hear, you know, it wasn't no real races. They all like to call it or whatever. I didn't know. You never didn't hear the word nigga, you know, growing up, you know, classmates, we all, you know, like brothers and sisters, teachers was good, everybody was good.
Sound like paradise, man. Let's keep that shit a secret, man.
Where was that?
In my hometown of Fordyce.
It's like a Twilight Zone town. Like it exists in another era.
So, but yeah, everybody, you know, is friendly, you know. I always feel welcome when I go home and stuff. I go home, like I said, around hunting season, you know. I always see more gliders when I go, but like I said, apparently it's more suns, but I always see more gliders and learn them when I go, you know, when I go home, so.
Yeah, suns don't consistently fill out the senses, so that shit just be, they be guessing that shit.
Yeah, true. Let me see. So this Disney thing is crazy.
Using the code OMG. That's
can you imagine?
Make sure that doesn't hire white.
Do you think like Bob has a say in the diversity stuff when they're casting people? Like
100%.
To what
he gives the director, I mean,
for each show, for each,
not that specifically, but like, you know, hey, I want every show to substantially.
Iger even has a chief diversity officer. Now, up until recently, that was Latondra Newton, who played a big part in dragging Disney full bore into its losing culture war by promoting discriminatory hiring practices and introducing gay, lesbian, transgender, non-binary, and other characters into Disney's children's animated series and films.
Is it like an all-across thing, like all of HR, or there's like that one specific person that kind of like... Because I forgot the lady's name. She's the head of the...
Oh, I know you're talking about the head of the diversity, yeah.
The African-American lady, yeah. So is that like kind of her deciding
She
that?
Oversees a lot of that, for sure. But it's pretty broad, I would say. There are other people in HR who are also.
So this is the woman who brought in all the trans characters into the fucking Disney movies and shit, and the gay pride flags all over Disney movies.
So, I don't understand. I just don't understand why that white man like go for this shit. Like, what's wrong with him?
He's terrified.
Yeah, well, this guy's also like, he's not a big wig. He's a cog in the wheel. And if you go to one of these places, you start speaking against diversity, man.
You're gone.
Like,
you're gone. These people, you never, and word gets around and you're out.
Yeah, you're out immediately. Like, I mean, like, think about it, man. Like, this woman probably is probably the least qualified person they have of any people in her position. Say they have 10 positions like this in their company. She's probably the least qualified of any of them.
There's nothing creative about her.
Yeah, one thing she is qualified at is revenge and retribution and things like that. So
she's
definitely going to have a heavy hand if you start running your mouth about whining about diversity.
I would say a relatively large percentage of our top writer creators happen to be gay. And a lot of
just by happenstance.
I mean, like, just like if you say whatever, I don't know, whatever, 10 or 15% of the population is gay, I would guess that 30 or 35% of our top writers gay. And so I think.
So the top writers at Disney, a huge swath of them are gay.
That's not surprising. So let me ask you this, Art. If they gave you a job like this, how do you fix it? But they said to keep it diverse.
There's no way to fix it, something like Disney when you have a diversity, because the creative people, the people who are writing the scripts and casting the movies and things like that, those people, that's the face. That's what you see with Disney. Like, just like when you're watching the game, there's producers out there. They pick which slides are going to go on, what stat is going to go up on the screen, which banner is going to go on the bottom of the screen. You know, what the, when they cut away to the to a screen, what's going on. So those people are the creative part of the thing. They, I think when you have 35% of your writers are LGBT, I think you're, it's too far gone. I don't think you can fix that. That's a huge number. That's a huge number. At a kids, at a place that makes content for kids, Disney allegedly makes content for kids, and 35% of your writers are gay. And you can't broach pedophilia or grooming. You can't say the word grooming. You can't say the word pedo in reference to them. So yeah, man. I mean, Disney. I don't think Disney can be saved.
No.
Lean into trans stories more than the average straight writer would.
And in an odd twist, you have to be a white Jewish guy to be considered for a C-suite job. More on that next week. But now let's meet Los Angeles-based Michael Giordano, a white male and Walt Disney Senior Vice President of Business Affairs.
I do like business affairs, so like negotiations for television.
Oh, okay, gotcha. Yeah. Nice. That's really cool. So
really, like on the creative side. You know, so a lot of it is you know, like knowing like the guild agreements and the union agreements and everything, like make offers for the writers and the actors who are gonna be out working on the show and the producers and the directors, and try to like, you know, get to a place where we can be able to deal with them, help the production to budget. And so much of my job is just the negotiating role. And then other people are doing kind of the drafting of the contracts. So,
So yeah, what's the negotiating like?
I'm like sitting down trying to figure out, okay, you know, what are we gonna pay this actor for this role? What do we think they want? What, you know?
Oh wow!
Strategize that. Everything from how you produce a show, how you distribute a show, how you exhibit a show, how you market a show, things like that. All of the negotiations and dealing with
that. Yeah.
One, well, actually, two of our brave undercover journalist and American swiper investigative reporters met Michael on the dating app Hinge. And aside from this story, which focused on Disney's overt discrimination against white men, you'll see later on in this report, and it'll be quite entertaining, Michael turns out to be quite the ladies' man.
How long have you been on, like, dating out?
Not very long.
Have you been going out?
Not a lot. Not a lot.
Anything, like, worth?
You know what's funny? No.
Let's dig right into Disney's blatant practices of discrimination. If you're wondering how Disney as a company looks at race, gender, and discrimination in the hiring process, about how they recruit and hire talent, look no further.
I think there are times when it's like so front and center, it's like great because that's the focus, you know? Like we have so many shows where we're casting and we're like, yeah, we're not even gonna see, you know, certain people for it because we need that particular role to,
yeah. So is it intentional that they want, like, they only look for diverse candidates for certain roles?
Yeah. I think there's certainly a belief that it's just good for society and they know. But there's also a belief that, like, we're going to make more money if we appeal to a wider variety of people. And it's a good thing. We have shareholders too, you know. And so diversity helps with that.
Diversity helps with financial incentives. Yeah. So is it like, do you think it's more so on that side? Or are you using, like, any good crisis gets put to use? Or?
I think it gives it regardless. But I think that there are, like, even conservative people who may not want to lean into it can easily make the argument that, like, we make more money when we appeal to a wider variety of people, and that means diversity.
Yeah.
There's a losing billion. I don't believe that. I don't believe you make more money. I don't believe you make more money when you make James Bond a black dude or you make the Equalizer a black woman. I don't think you make more money when you do that.
They've been losing billions.
Yeah, I think that's a blind spot for them. I think that sounds good on paper, but I think in reality, you know, you make fucking Superman a fucking a disabled trans guy, it's like, I mean, no one wants to see that. People are hating. Look at Romeo and Juliet. No one likes it. Look at Little Mermaid. People don't like that shit. That stuff does. I don't think they're making money. I think they're just saying that because they're being led by black women and gay people, and they're in their own bubble are saying, yeah, this is great. But they're not looking at the people, like what it's doing. Like when a movie bombs, that black woman who's in charge over there at Disney, she just thinks it's because everyone's racist. She doesn't think it's because, yo, we don't want to see a gay Hulk. It turns pink instead of green when he gets angry. We don't want to see that. She'll just call everybody homophobic and wash her hands of it. And you know what I'm saying? And not have to, you know?
The same shit they did with that Romeo and Juliet when the Juliet was just like not fucking beautiful.
Yeah.
We don't give a fuck if, like, they could have put, like, what's the little skinny chick from out west or whatever? The one that did the list. What's she do? Spider-Man or some shit?
Zendaya.
Yeah, yeah. If it was her, it would have been like, hey, shit, at least she fine. At least she beautiful, you know? But you throw a fucking terrible fucking sun lady up there and call her Juliet, that shit is just weird, man. Nobody want to see that bullshit.
Yeah, but they'll say they don't have to answer for it because it's not a failure. It's a failure of society. We failed. They tried to show diversity, and white racist MAGA people rejected it, which emboldens them even more. Yeah. Like if you're woke and you're, you know what I'm saying, and you're all with the, because like Disney, they're all woke, so they're all Democrats and shit. They see that as, okay, let's double down on this shit.
Yeah. As much as like, I pray like Trump wins and all that shit. I'm looking forward to the post-MAGA excuse and the post-MAGA, you know, like the whole post, like everything is just, oh, MAGA Republicans or MAGA this and MAGA that. How long do you think they'd be able to keep that whole narrative going with MAGA after his last term?
MAGA is basically like what the alt-right was and what the Tea Party was before. So it's just this extension of white groups that have emerged over the years that we've seen. So I think, you know, they'll just come up with another white group will emerge, and it'll just be, you know, they'll be the new MAGA. They'll be like the Tea Party, like the alt-right was. So it's like any time white people consolidate and show pride and start a movement, it's going to be considered racist.
Yeah.
And then if you guys don't like anything that black people do, you have to like everything that black people do. So if you don't like anything that black people do, that's going to be attributed to racism. And then we're going to have to double down on it because you guys can't win. We can't let you win. We can't let racism win. So we just made the Hulk turn pink when he gets mad. So now we got to make Aquaman got to be a fucking one-eyed
transgender
lesbian and shit. You know what I'm saying? Because you guys, it's you guys. It's not us. You guys are the problem. So yeah, that's kind of like the cauldron we're in right now with all this woke stuff. Even though woke is starting to go away a little bit,
nah, that's still like away.
Hanging on. It's still hanging on.
Nah, I mean woke is very unpopular right now. Like
yeah, it is.
Very
popular.
Kids start
very unpopular.
It's uncool. No,
I got you on that, but they're also entrenched though. Like they said, no matter how unpopular woke is, Disney's got to fire 35% of their writers. and take on 35% of lawsuits. Each one of those writers, if they get fired, are going to file a lawsuit, claim discrimination, and write a book or go on, do an interview about all the stuff they seen. I left my sandwich in the refrigerator in the break room one day, and no one ate it because they think I'm gay and I might have AIDS. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that's the type of shit they can, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Like, seriously, they can do that. They can do that. They can go anywhere with that shit. So if you got 35% of your writers are fucking from that group, and then you got a black woman heading like the whole shit, yo, you can't get rid of these people, man. Like, that ain't gonna be easy.
There's gonna be a lot more billions lost before they do any kind of reversal.
Yeah, exactly. It's not gonna be easy, man. It's not going to be easy, man.
They're reshaping our culture. They have an important job to do. And if they have to lose all the stockholders' money to do it, they're fine with that because they're on a holy mission.
Yeah. Yeah, man. It's like they can say anything. Like, those gay people in there can be sitting in the break room talking about white men. Oh, my God. Fragile white men. God, white men are so fragile. And they can be in the break room talking that shit loud, audibly. But that white guy, yo, if one of them sneezes, he better, excuse, bless you. If he don't say bless you before they fucking wipe their nose, he's a racist. They've put themselves in a box. It's kind of like when you invite a family member, like your fucking ain't shit uncle that needed a place to stay for a few days. Now it's 6 months later and this nigga still in there. His feet stink. He leaves his fucking hair in the sink when he shaves. He pisses on the seats. He's got some crackhead bitch sneaking in at night, eating up all your kids' fucking Doritos and snack packs and shit. And you can't get rid of them now. You know what I'm saying? You can't get rid of them.
That's when you hope he goes in the drive-by.
Yeah, but the drive-by will probably be at your house. And he won't get hit. But yeah, it's like, yo, they've this woke shit, they've entrenched that shit. That shit is entrenched. Those people are in there. That black woman who they put in charge of diversity at Disney, who hires people now, the HR black woman, LaShawn or whatever her name was. Yo, even if you get rid of her, think about how much damage she's done in hiring over the years that she's been there.
She basically wanted to abolish anything that the white man has done. But black females in general, even my mom, like, even though super straight, you know, obviously she's old school, they like that gay shit. It's just the weirdest shit, man, with black women with that shit. I don't know. Oh, let me just hang out with them. I'm like, mom, it's fucking gay.
It's all women. That's all women, man.
Yeah, it's the truth.
It's all women, but black women are a little bit different because they like, just like anything, they do it a little bit extra. You know what I'm saying? Just like anything. Mm-hmm. So yeah. Like they're gonna be more extra with it. You probably wouldn't see a white gay guy beating the shit out of a white woman in a white neighborhood in the street, and people just standing around like cheering it on, like, oh, they fighting. But if you go to a hood, a gay dude can fight a girl. You know what I'm saying? A gay dude can fight a girl in a black hood. Like, they just different, man. They just do it differently, man. Yeah, but though they're entrenched in these places, man. Like, you want to, if you think you just going to, oh, woke is not popular anymore, everything's all good now. No. Woke isn't popular now, and they're pissed off, and they're all in high places. And they're pissed off, and now they're going to try to show you. And, of course, that's going to make it more unpopular. Yeah, definitely. I'll give you that them being in all these high places and in essential positions in almost every institution, and them feeling like, oh, okay, the world is turning against us, we got to go extra woke. Yeah, that's going to fucking, yeah, that may cause the culture war that they're talking about. That may cause a revolution, yeah. Because they're just going to double down. They're just going to up yours, pal, even more. Because they're in positions to fuck you. They have fuck you positions. That black woman in charge of Disney, she's got a fuck you position. She's in charge of hiring. That's the biggest fuck you position you can have. I'm in charge of who's hired here. And like the white guy said on camera, he said, they're not hiring any white guys anymore. White guys aren't being hired anymore.
Straight white guys.
Yeah, that's no secret.
Yeah. And she can say that.
Hey. So on the in reality, in the mind of some people, she can be racist, right? No, because that's the person of power that
he can.
Nah, she don't have no power. That's the way we play it. We play both sides. She don't, you know, say, yeah, she can't be racist. She still can't, even she can't be racist. No, we can never be racist. Yeah,
but I don't know. I don't know where they come with that mindset that they can't be racist and they're doing everything that is racist.
It's a power play.
I think it insults black intelligence to presume that they aren't smart enough to be racist.
No, but it's still a power play. It's like a, it's kind of like a, like it's like kids at a lunch table. It's a like, it's like if I tag you, right? And I say, tag, no tag back. You know what I'm saying?
Basically. It's like some kiddie
shit. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Or like I'm touching this refrigerator, and this refrigerator makes me you can't tag me unless I'm touching the refrigerator, I can't be tagged. So you gotta wait till I move away from the refrigerator, then you can tag me. But as long as I'm touching this refrigerator, it's the safety refrigerator, I can't be tagged. You know what I'm saying? It's like, you know, it's just like a game. Like, you know, it's not that deep.
Yeah, but once they get the reparations, all that's going to stop.
Yeah, right. This guy doesn't know.
Hey,
much.
Man, I ain't going to flex. If we get reparations, I don't think
everybody getting rich.
Yo, everybody getting rich, but I'm just talking about how unsafe it will be for like all some people.
Guns.
Everybody's killing. Guns, if everybody's got $1 million.
No, I'm talking about some people gonna be like robbing. Yeah, some people going to be robbing motherfuckers. Like, hey, I know he got money.
Every gun store going to be like literally empty, man. You go to the gun store, they going to be, it's going to be a ghost town in the gun store. There'll be fucking cobwebs on the shelves of the gun store. We'll buy every gun in the fucking world. Salute to Tomcat. He says, I'm so tired of the B-dubs running stuff. Shout out to Tomcat. He says, and if Trump wins, he's going to get like Kennedy. I don't know about that. I think that they are going to punish, the liberals are going to punish the world if Trump wins. They're going to riot and they're going to fucking fuss. They're going to do their version. They're going to do a
insurrection
January 6th, but they're going to do it like a year long January 6th. Hey, and they're going to be like, we're justified because y'all did it January
6th. Hey, I think we at the point now where after this debate, though, if Biden like does terrible, he obviously going to be high, but it's supposed to be what, like 3 hours long?
What?
This debate coming up.
Oh, Lord.
Yeah, it's supposed
to be like, it's an hour and a half. I think it's an hour and a half. I think.
Okay. All right. So an hour and a half. He really can't like. How long was the State of the Union? Was that like 45 minutes?
I don't know.
But he's going to be high. It's shit. So it's just like, I don't know if the Adderall would be able to stay that long in the system at a peak where he won't have that moment. But anyway, they're saying that, a lot of people saying that, if he doesn't do well in this debate, if he had like one of those moments where, you know, he just becomes spacey or does the mumble jumble or whatever, that they'll try to replace him at the last minute. And at the last minute, if they replace him, especially if it's after the DNC, the Democrat like person won't even be on ballot. So it'd be basically just like Trump running by himself.
You think they would never do that. I'm in Pennsylvania, right? And John Fetterman, who, like, I'm talking about, Dr. Oz is like a, whatever you want to say about Dr. Oz, he's a very, very well-spoken man, a very, very smart man. And John Fetterman, after he had that stroke, before the stroke, he was an idiot. But after he had that stroke, he was basically a vegetable. And they ran him. And he was, every appearance he had was embarrassing, exponentially more embarrassing than the last one, to the point it was like a skit. It was almost comical. It was like Bizarro World. He won.
I remember that, but I'm just saying that was what, 2 years ago?
But he won.
That was 2 years ago. But I feel like nowadays, that whole shit with the political fear of anything that's Trumpish is like insurrection and bad, and he's a threat to democracy. I think that whole fear vote is done. And I think that at this point, I feel like the Democrats know that is no chance for like Biden. So they finna figure something out, and I think they're gonna have a master plan because they're a little bit more.
What candidate they gonna come on, man? The only reason they running Biden is because he the only one that can face off with Trump. If they had someone else,
that's why I said they probably just gonna take this loss. They just gonna take this L.
Nah, they ain't gonna take no loss. Cause you think they're gonna take a loss? They're gonna fight tooth and nail. They have power. No one with power gives it up easily. They're not going to give it up. Yo, do you understand that even if Trump wins, they're going to fight it in court, talk about they stole the election?
No, I get that. And that's what I think that's their master plan, is to fight it in court for like 2.5 years or whatever it is. And then they're going to do this whole impeachment shit. And I feel like they're going to find a way to win an impeachment type of thing. They don't have a chance. I don't think they have a chance of winning the election, bro.
I don't know. I think it's November is what, 4 months away, 3 months away? Man, that's so much time, man. I think you guys gotta everyone who thinks that the Democrats are gonna lose, you haven't been watching lately, man. Do you understand? They play dirty. Like, they're not going to, you're not dealing with somebody who plays the game right. Like, it's like cheating. It's like saying that, like, it's like you're playing against a team that cheats and it's the third quarter and you're up by 10 and you're like, yeah, we got this in the bag. No, the fuck you don't. Like, it's just like the whole quarter left, man.
No,
I got shit in the bag, though.
No, I get it. I'm not saying, like, and I think that, like, the Republicans, the independent voters, are they kind of figuring out the plan, like the whole thing. They want us to lax and be like, oh, it's down in the bag, and then not show up for voting and type of shit. But I think we passed that too as America. America's frustrated as fuck, bro. You got your crazy fucking vote blue no matter who, no matter what type of people in the Trump deranged.
but the Trump deranged vote ain't as high as it was, bro. And you got to remember, like, he didn't lose by much. And the majority of the people that voted for Biden in 2020 was Trump deranged and all this other shit. And he's bad for democracy and blah, 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 blah. And that shit go from like 20% of the vote of Trump deranged, man, hate Trump, never Trump was. That shit probably at like 7% now.
I don't know, man. It's so much time left for something to happen that galvanizes the people. There's so much time. Like, you gotta understand, like, when whatever happens, they're gonna seize on it and they're gonna jump. Their base is waiting for that. Their base is like a girl who's like fooling around with a guy on a couch and she's wet and she wants to screw him, but she knows that she shouldn't. And all she's waiting for him to say is, I love you. And if he says, I love you, he's getting the draws.
Yeah.
Now she's waiting for that. And that's what her she's hinging whether she's going to give him some draws or on. But that's the same way Democrats are waiting for that racist
thing to happen.
Right. So, like,
we could be fighting for Israel by then.
But once it happens, they're going to. You thinking that, like, it got to be a certain thing. It got to come in a certain. All they got to do is. All they got to do is happen. And they'll be like, huh? And they'll release onto it and they'll jump onto whatever it is. You know what I mean?
Yeah. I feel you. I think that all fucking glider cops need to have a national meeting, like a Klans meeting or some shit, and just say, no, just no. No matter what the circumstance is, don't do it. If it's some people, don't do it, bro. Just wait till after November. All you glider police officers, my fellow men, boys in blue, just relax, guys. It's okay.
Don't go trying to arrest any career criminals that are high and passing bad 20s.
Don't do it, bro. Don't do it. Because if that fucking military kid happened in fucking September, that shit would probably be the biggest story in America.
Yeah, but even him, though, like, that don't got legs because he's not somebody blacks want to latch on. It's just like I was talking about Sha'Carri Richardson earlier. Do you know they got U.S. track stars that have gone to Yale and Harvard and are great black women that have great, you know, traveled all over the world and been in all organizations? The one that blacks gravitate, the only track star blacks love is the little hood rat from Dallas.
Yeah, because the what was that? The one that had replaced her, she was at Harvard or Yale or some shit, right?
Yeah.
The black girl with the braids.
Yeah, but everybody on the track team's black. The track U.S. track team is 100% black women. The women's side.
Yeah, and the fact that she got replaced by the educated black woman that came from fucking the Ivy League school to have a great father and a great family. And we just didn't even embrace her at all. Yeah.
Very nobody even knew her name.
I still don't know her name. I'm sorry.
Nobody wanted to know her name. No one cared. The Good Morning America them tried to, you know, give her a special, but no one cared. Black people are gonna gravitate. It's gonna be a certain type of guy that gets killed that's gonna that black people gonna care about. And it's gonna be like, you know. It's not that airman. That airman wasn't it. He doesn't move the needle with black people. So that person that gets killed is gonna be like, it's gonna happen. Or something is gonna happen. Some racial firestorm is gonna happen. And Republicans or conservatives are gonna be looking like, this is stupid, and it's gonna be like, yeah, it's stupid, but it's resonating. And once
you don't think it's gonna be some Middle East stuff.
No.
The Middle East shit not gonna move the election as much as everybody think. I think the Middle East shit will probably take Trump very close to, or basically win in Michigan. But after that, I don't think that shit will make any effect.
Yeah, like this is gonna be a black and white thing. Even if it's a Hispanic, like, it's not gonna move it. It's gonna have to be a white officer and a black victim, or a white person and a black victim.
Hey, you know what's funny though? A black player. They've been talking about that whole black vote shit, whatever. Saying that Trump about to get 20% of the black vote. And I'm just thinking, like, man, if he gets 20% of the black vote, that means he has to get like fucking 30% of Sun men. Yeah, because Sun women are 98% gonna vote blue, like, no matter who.
Exactly.
So I don't see it.
I don't see it at all, because black men are not very smart. And that's just, I'm gonna just leave it at that, man. You can take the $5 challenge if you want to, on this Good Friday, support the channel. But if not, that's fine. Salute to everybody who joined us today, man. Same black time, same black channel. Out of here. Peace out.
Peace.
Peace.
Peace. Peace.